In this video, you will learn the method to install the fuel pump on John Deere 6081 engine. If you have carried out the overhauling on your John Deere 6081, make sure that the timing mark on the camshaft gear is perfectly aligned with the timing mark on crankshaft gear. These are the two timing marks on your John Deere 6081 crank and cam. Rotate the engine and insert screwdriver, Phillips screwdriver, in the timing pin hole. Press the screwdriver until engaged with the hole in the flywheel. You will hear the clicking sound when it engages with the flywheel. There you can see it is engaged. Now confirm that your number one cylinder is at TDC compression stroke. When number one cylinder is at TDC compression stroke, intake and exhaust valves for number one cylinder will be closed and both rocker arms will be loose. Rotate injection pump drive hub until marks on drive hub B and pointer A are aligned. This is the drive hub and the pointer. The B is the drive hub and A is the pointer. Both these marks should be aligned before installing and locking the fuel pump. There you can see from the inspection hole, we have placed the pump on the engine block. There are four studs. There you can see these two points are perfectly aligned, and when we move our drive hub, the timing will be out like this. There you can see they are a little bit, their alignment is a little bit out. Now there are four studs on the engine block where the pump will be installed. This is the front drive gear, the drive gear of the fuel pump. First you have to install the nut on the stud in the engine block to make sure that your pump is fixed. There are four stud. Tight all of them with the help of universal and extension of 12 inch or bigger. After locking the front nut on the fuel pump, install the front cover of the fuel pump. This is the front cover on the fuel pump we are installing. After tightening the front cover and completion of the assembly, after engine is fully assembled, loose the pipe, return pipe on the fuel pump, and prime the fuel pump. There you can see when the air stops coming from the fuel pump return line, it means that fuel pump is primed. The air bubbles are still coming from this line. After the air bubbles are stopped, we will lock this nut and we will tighten this nut. We will tighten this line. Now loose the lines on the injectors and then crank the engine to bleed the air from here, to bleed the air from the fuel system and prime the fuel line. When all the lines are loose, we will crank the engine. The proper method for priming the fuel lines is to loose the injector line one by one. First you have to loose one line and then you have to crank the engine, then second line and then crank the engine. But we have loosened all the lines at a time and we are cranking the engine. There you can see the fuel is coming from the fuel lines, and after the fuel is filled in the fuel lines, tighten the nuts of the fuel line and the engine will be started. That is the second type of the fuel pump, P7100. That is, it's on the bottom of this pump you can see the access plug. When you remove the access plug, there will be a timing pin tool inside. That is the timing pin tool. On the bottom of this pump you can see the access plug. When you remove the access plug, there will be a timing pin tool inside, and you have to take out the timing pin tool and put it back in reverse direction. The cut on the timing pin tool will be engaged with the pump timing tool like this. When pin is engaged, the timing pin tool will be locked with this help of this pin.
In the left picture, the timing pin tool is engaged. Here you can see.
You can install the pump onto the engine with the timing pin tool locked on the timing pin, the fuel pump timing tool, and then you can easily install the fuel pump. After installation, don't forget to remove that timing pin tool. That fuel pump can rotate freely and the timing pin tool is not damaged. Take out the timing pin tool and put it in reverse direction. After installation of the pump, don't forget to remove the timing pin tool and place it back in the access plug to make sure that next time when you need it, it is still there. Thanks for watching the video. Subscribe the channel for more videos like this.